Jesus' name. Jesus' name. How long were you married to Ray for?
10 years.
For about 10 years. Stand on the altar. Everybody listen to me. Let me tell you something. When God sends a prophet, we return to what has been done years. And we break it and move you back into your purpose. Listen to me. The Lord told me. Do you know the reason why the Lord is speaking? The Lord said to me to tell you, you are a good man. You are a good man. I see an angel that is bringing a parcel. The parcel is coming close. The Andre Walden. What's your name?
DeAndre Walden.
My God. Because the angel has brought the package. And what the Lord said to me was that what happened to Ray will not stand in the family anymore. Wait. I see multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis. Multiple. What happened to her?
She had multiple sclerosis.
Let me tell you. She didn't have multiple sclerosis. It is only doctors that said it. But when she,
Wait.
Valentine's Day is 14 February, right?
Yes.
Oh, that's why they made you to cry on Valentine's Day. Because they wanted it to pass on the 11th of February. 11th of February, 2017. Ask it for me, when did she pass? 11th February.
Yes.
Jesus. Let me tell you why they said it's multiple sclerosis. When she was born, there was a good friend of the mother that came to, when a child is born, they came to celebrate. You understand how they do it? But the mother's friend was a witch. So when she came and said, wow, beautiful lady, and she gave a kiss on the peg of Ray, she projected multiple sclerosis. Let me tell you this. If you don't know, the multiple sclerosis she died from is not today or tomorrow. It started when she was very, 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 very young. So many years. But it comes and it goes. It comes and it goes. And it comes and it goes. So although people saw her very alive, taken and active, she had it on her.
Yeah.
Even before you met her, she had it. If you don't know, I'm telling you. So that's why doctors could not prevent. Because it was not a doctor's power to do it. It was a spiritual matter. But let me tell you something. Whatever was also projected in your family, I've entered into your family and I've seen your family tree. But the good news is that some of your family members, they serve God and they were good. I see a lot of women that serve God. I saw one lady was called Mary. I saw one woman that was also called Joyce. And I saw Thelma. And I also saw Stephanie. And I also saw Regina. These are the family members, old family members who are dead and gone. And they serve God well.
Yes.
Listen, I called about 5 names. Who is called Joyce?
My mother.
My God. My God. Let me tell you something. I came here to prophesy to you that the story today is changed. I said it's changed. Because all the good things that happened in your family of all these 5 women I mentioned, these 5 women, they helped homeless people. They used to support the community and it has built a great altar for them. Let me tell you something. Your time has come. You are going to shine. The Lord will keep you. You, let me tell you something. You love God. You love people. You are always there for people. The Lord said, don't worry at all. He's going to remember you. He will surprise you. And the Lord said to me that you need to go and speak to a lady that was connected to your wife. I'm talking about faith. I'm talking about faith. The Lord says, go and speak to faith. Ask him for who's called faith.
Oh, mother.
Your wife's mother was called faith.
Yes.
Go and tell your mother that she needs your wife's mother to fast for 2 days. Because what the friend did is still lingering. But when she finished fasting, just tell her, we have come to church. We are in a recovery crusade. God has taken care of it. You'll be blessed. You'll be happy again. The reason why I took that time is that the Lord says, I should give you a new identity. As I'm talking now, Father, what am I saying? As I'm talking now, what is today's date? Today's date is 5th March. 5th March. You had planned a birthday with Rai. Because Rai's birthday was going to be in 2 days' time. Rai's birthday was going to be on the 7th of March, which is 2 days' time. And they have made arrangements of that particular restaurant they were supposed to go and sit at. And even if they are going to the restaurant, they're going to sit at table number 5. Table number 5. That's where they were going to sit. The Lord said to me that, so as the birthday is approaching, it is hurting you more. Because I see 7th. Because on the 7th, that's when she was going to be at the year of 45 years. That was going to be the birth year of your wife that is passed. But the Lord says, I should take your tie and I should tie it around your neck again as a new identity. As a new identity. And I prophesy, your life will never be the same. Somebody scream!
Hallelujah!
Somebody scream!
Hallelujah!
Somebody scream! Somebody scream! Come. Listen, I see a number. I see a number. I see a number. I see a number of a location. I see 7210. 7210. What is that?
That's the location of my business.
Location of your business. Wait. Are you sure location of your business? I see 7210 Rutherford Road. Listen to me. When I get to my spirit right now, it's not in this church. 7 angels with the presence of the Holy Spirit have taken me out of this church. And we are flew in the air. And the Lord says, I should go to your business location to go and do something for you. So as I got there, I saw 7210 Rutherford Road. When I got there, it was not only 720, but I saw Sweet E. Sweet E. That's where...
Yes.
Clap your hands to the name of the Lord. Listen, when I got there, listen, the reason why the Lord took me there is this. I don't know what you do, but I come to tell you this. Everybody hear me and hear me well. Put this one on camera very well so that you listen to it over and over again. I see this lady enter into her premises, and I saw some ladies who have come there, and they have told her, train me, exercise. When it happened, I saw that one of the ladies that will come already has hypertension, high blood pressure. So because the lady that has come there has high blood pressure, the lady who is coming is not well, she's sick. So whilst this lady is training her, the lady will collapse and she will die in front of her. And it will call police to come in. And it was going to be a 2-year investigation. And as they were investigating, they will try to lock down her business. And that's what has been planned. So the Lord says, as we are here, we should break that attack. Because otherwise, that is what is happening. That's why the Lord took me to that place of the address. I can hear somebody. I can hear somebody. Sister, bring her. Bring her to me. Bring her to me. Bring her to me. Sister, don't cry. God reveals to redeem. God reveals to redeem. But I'm telling her to watch these three names. If they come around where she works, she should tell them to go and do medical checkup first. Okay. The first name I saw, hear me, these names, let them go and do their medical checkups well. Ask her for me whether the death was a killing death. Killing.
Yes.
It was killing.
Yes.
Follow me. No, sorry. It was here. Here. The angel showed me here. I'm sorry. The angel didn't come there. The angel came here. I need to be sensitive. Come. So the child was, is it killing? You know, the kind of killing. Is it the kind of killing that police came inside? That police came in. And they were investigating.
Yes.
And I want her to understand that are the police still investigating or they have closed the case? Because spiritually, the Lord said to me that there is not a close up on the case. The case is not a close up. Ask her for me.
Yes.
Is the case pending now?
Yes. Still
follow
open.
Me. Clap your hands to the name of the Lord. Because in the spiritual realm, the Lord took me there. The Lord said, Daniel, there's a lady sitting there that the child is killed. And the case is not closed. And the case is still pending. And the Lord said to me that the reason why the Lord showed me to pray for her is two things. Number one, the people that committed that atrocity, they are still lingering around. You know. Because always when you are moving about, you feel that some people are following you. Oh. And the Lord says, if you don't pray for her, they think, because the Lord says the case is not closed. So the people think this woman will testify against them. So now, let them follow her, and they will not just kill her, but they will just let another car hit her. So that it will happen as if it's not them, but it is the same people. But the Lord says, Daniel, because he's at Empowerment Temple today, go and expose those people and go, oh my God, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God, Jesus. Lift up your right hand. Lift up your right hand. Get me more envelopes on the altar as well. Lift up your right hand. Mommy, don't cry. That's why you are living in fear. You are living in panic. That's what is happening. This woman is in fear. She's in panic. The Lord said to me that they are following. There are four people. Two black guys and two Hispanic guys. Sit down. Sit down. Let's have to sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Dr. Jamil, that's what the Lord is saying to me. So this woman, you have been living in perpetual fear. Because the police cannot comprehend what actually happened. It was an issue about money. That's how it happened. And they thought the guy has taken their money. That's why they killed him. Ah! Shout Jesus. Shout Jesus. Listen, is there anybody here who is ready to sit on the chair today? I said, is there anybody here who is ready to sit in their new chair of destiny today? I don't want you to miss it. When I call for the chair, run to it. My God. My God. By Empowerment Temple, mommy, look at me. The Lord is saying to me, they are going to be arrested tonight. I said, they are going to be arrested tonight. One angel has entered into a house number. One house number is number 8729. And one of them, their house number is 1190. One of their house number is 3320. The Lord says, angels are fighting for you. Oh, oh, hallelujah. 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 Someone shout fire.
Fire!
Shout fire!
Fire!
Shout fire!
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 Shh. Lift her for me. 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 Give me some of the envelopes. You will be part of the people that will sit on the chair, okay? When I call for the chair, make sure you come. Just give me. Jesus. Can you get my face towels for me? Get them for me, my face towel. Get them for me fast. Mommy, look at me. Mommy, the Lord said to me that recently they were going to try to put you on antidepressants. Antidepressants. They were putting you on antidepressants. The Lord says he has canceled the depression from you. The Lord said it has been canceled from you. The Lord said it has been canceled from you. Ah, listen. Dr. Jamil, the Lord is saying to me that as I'm speaking right now, the issue that is going on, because of the fear, she was going to seek for protection. I see police protection. You're going to seek for. The Lord says you don't need police protection anymore because the angels have taken over. Oh! My God, my God, my God, my God.